everyone. My name is Pragati, and we are from Mahanadi. So before going to the topic, I just want to show you a video clip so that we can understand whether you are sleeping or awake, okay?
Breakfast, Didi.
Didi?
You have to guess
what you are. Didi, guess what?
Bola.
Kya?
Oh, pimpin. Didi, batao na. Kya karo?
So, any guesses?
Any guesses?
Sure?
Yes.
Yeah, it's Himalaya.
Breakfast, Didi.
So, our topic for the day is case study on Himalaya. So, the founder, that is MNL, actually when he was in Burma, like the forest of Burma, so he was found up at the village, he's seen a villager using a root of a herbal of like some local plant, and with that use of like one elephant got hurt, so it was like the hurt was like fully vanished and the elephant like became calm. So he was so fascinated about that, so he thought that he will continue this and he will go for a business in natural and Ayurvedic aspects. Here is the brief contents we are covering today: introduction, product segments, competitors, its market size and share, revenue, promotions and the conclusion. Now, here is a brief introduction about the company. The Himalaya Drug Company was established in 1930 by Mr. M. Manal, and he believed in converting the herbs and all into tablets which are consumed by people, and they motivated them to use Ayurveda, and he also validated Ayurveda with scientific research and development, and then he scientific research and development, and he also consulted with the medical practitioners who gave them the medicines which are useful for its accessibility and its promotion. Next, his CEO is the parent company of the Himalaya Drug Company, Himalaya Global Holdings. CEO is Philip Hayden. Its headquarters in Bangalore, India. The world's first natural anti-hypertensive drug named Serpina was launched in 1934 by Himalaya, and it's operated in more than 90 countries. Next, there are several product segments under this company like personal care, pharmaceuticals, baby care, animal health, wellness, Himalaya for moms, and nutrition. So it was earlier a pharmaceutical company till 2001, which 96% of the revenue arise from there. Afterwards, it diversified into personal care, animal health, wellness, and recently into baby care and Himalaya for moms. 45% of the revenue contributed from personal care, 30% from pharmaceuticals, and 14% and 5% from baby care and others. Next. They are the main competitors of the Himalaya, like Dabur, HUL, Patanjali, P&G. Their old competitors are Dabur and P&G. But recently the major competitor which came into light was Patanjali, because their also major motto is Ayurvedic, and people switched more to the Patanjali. But still it's a tough competition between Himalaya and Patanjali. By CEO said that there is a main differentiator which differentiates the company from others, that is it's more effort in the research pattern, research work, where like very different products are there, and according to the demand of the people and the market, it changes its profile. So these are the competitors, and the major competitors are Patanjali. So when we go to market size and share, so the market size is 17,594 crore rupees, and the market share of Himalaya is 10%. Comparatively it's low, but the best thing about Himalaya is with the changing of years, there is an increment in the revenue of the company. That's why it's still surviving in the, you know, this competitive world of FMCG. And the best part is it's Ayurvedic, so people do choose it, but there is a competition between Patanjali because they both have the same line, that baseline, that is Ayurvedic. And next slide. So we have a comparison of 3 years' revenue. That is in 2013-14, the revenue was 1,300 crore rupees, and in 2014 and 15, it was 1,450 crore rupees. And in 2015 and 16, that is 1,800 rupees crore. So from this we can see there is an increase in the revenue by increasing rate. So promotions. Before that, I want to say, like, we all admire our mother and grandmother, right?
Yeah.
Like how beautiful they are, how their like hair is, how clean their skin is, like how beautiful they are. Like, we all admire. But the difference between their age and their like their our age is that, like, the pollution is increased, right? So we all families have some secrets in our, like, how to get a better skin, how to have a better health. So the secrets given by each family is that there is a secret of about a glowing skin. So we can get from that Himalaya. And I have two friends who are using Himalaya products. One is Vaibhavi. Okay, she is using Himalaya neem cream face wash. By using that, her skin got clear, like it's very clean. As you can see her, she has so fair and clean skin. And I don't know about like about boys, but we all girls like long hair, right girls?
Yes.
Yes.
One answer.
Yes.
Okay, we'll go with yes. So, we have nine. You can see her hair. She's very fashionable. Okay? She's having long hair. She uses Himalaya shampoos. Like in Himalaya shampoos, we have very there are different types, like for gentle wash, for silky hair, and then for dandruff, and many others are there. So you can choose according to your requirement. And so we can say that the Himalaya's focus has been shifted from Ayurvedic ideas to herbal personal care. Like they understood that, like they can segment their companies. Like only medicines are not the only things, because they have the all knowledge of natural things which can get beautified to your body as well as health. And next was brand icon, the granny can convey her knowledge of age-old health tips and Himalaya products. I said, like, we all have that tips, right? Grandmother and mother tips. How to have a better skin or better hair. Next, reach customers through advertisement. We all know that, like, if a company wants, like, there should be an awareness, so they can go for advertisement, they can go for, you know, demos, they can go for offers, they can do many things. So that comes under it. And customer care portal. Like, if you have any complaint, any problem regarding Himalaya, you can, we have a Himalaya's customer care number, so you can call there and you can have your queries done. And next is marketing strength is research and not in advertising. Like they do advertise, but their main focus is like they will spend their more money in doing research and development so that they can produce a better product for you all. Next, media interviews. Like we all know that for everything, like some or the other controversies come, like this product is having that, this product. So to always have a clarified image, a transparency between the customer and the producers, the media interviews are like what new products are like produced for that awareness also. Then offer flow displays, use coupons, offer samples, demos, offer posters, offer monthly periodic special. So you know when Himalaya is going into medicines, so they were the doctors were also like, they would have accepted it, like, yeah, it is good. They even have, like, whenever they used to write a prescription, they used to, like, use their name. So they used to be displayed everywhere. Like, we can always see over. And conclusion, the company is at a growing stage and expecting rupees 3,400 crores in 2020. And, like, that means that it is increasing rate. It's increasing. At present, Himalaya's biggest vertical is personal care, contributing 45% to total sales, followed by pharmaceutical 30%, baby care 15%, animal health 2%, Himalaya for moms 2%, nutrition 2%, and wellness 4%.
mother care products are also produced like before pregnancy and afterwards, like how mothers can care for themselves also. And the company's differentiator is clearly their research and capabilities. Like according to the requirement of the customers, the products are produced. Thank you, everyone.